interesting stuff there from Penny and the coaches. For the high-tech side, they mentioned something about the scouting reports, and I agree with them. This is a whole new team. They've got a whole new coaching staff. They've got Michael Fay as a new import. I pretty much think that high-tech can pretty much throw away the scouting reports they have and dedicate their first few minutes to just learning what this new team is going to be all about. What do you think about this Pete?
Well, you know, he's absolutely right. Coach Raha is absolutely right. If it was me doing the scouting report, it'd be tough right now because you got a new coaches. You got two big men now in their half-court game. Definitely going to be a problem for high-tech. And in the terms of they made a few adjustments on some guards also. I see some new faces that I didn't see recently in the past games. So it's going to be an interesting one with a different mindset of a different coach. Might be different plays. You know, we got to wait and see.
Yeah. Another thing the Mono Vampire manager mentioned is about the fast breaks. And what you said about Michael Fay and Anthony McLean being a good half-court tandem, they haven't really much shown that they can work well in the transition defense. They got ran out by Xavier Alexander and Justin Howard in the recent game. And this high-tech team is actually pretty good in the fast break game with Stephen Thomas throwing the baseball passes, Chris Charles running the floor. That's going to be something that Mono Vampires have really got to work out with.
Yep. Either way, you know, like the defending champions, high-tech Bangkok City is definitely versatile in a lot of ways, both defensive and offensive, especially transition. They got Christian Charles, the reigning MVP, who can run up and down just like Freddie Goldstein and Tyler Lamb. So, and of course, the legend, Stephen Thomas, being the centerpiece for them.
So right now we're introducing the players here on the court. Freddie Goldstein there with a nice, clean new haircut and some clean new KD8 Christmases there.
As he headbutts Stephen Thomas's chest.
See the return of Ataporn Lertmalaiporn. He was away for a couple of games. Another veteran in Pierpong Pirun.
I noticed we're not seeing the new youngin for high-tech.
No, this is going to be a heated game, so maybe high-tech's going to be looking for that veteran leadership in every one of their players. You're going to see, as you mentioned, the Dai Kong Kum coming back in to the lineup. He's been a player who's been around for a very long time. He's going to be very useful.
That's a very good point, TK.
That's the lineup for the high-tech Bangkok City. And here come in the Mono Vampires.
But before they bring him out, here's the vampire ladies. Extra support from the Mono Vampire girls.
Always good support there.
The first player, number 8, Suran Yu In Moon. 39, Bat Kun Ganat Samote. Number 7, Shopper Titapon Do Wei Roar. Prayer number 69, Pam Nurong Pan Apirong Wilai Chai. Prayer number 3, Teo Rashide Kruatiwa. Prayer number 36, Sorot Suntasi. Prayer number 91, Sing Shunachon Glahan. Prayer number 22, Yap Shaiwat Gadam. Player number 70, Foylan Bagyan. Player number 45, Migers Frey. And player number 30, Vicky Anthony McCray. The team manager, Mr. Abishal Seiko. Head coach, Mr. Suntan Pong Mawinton. Assistant coach, Mr. Tong Kiet Singha Seni. And assistant coach, Mr. China Long Sun Triapa. And the referee for this game, referee Mr. Nelson Shan from Malaysia. Umpire 1, Mr. Kimal from Indonesia. Umpire 2, Mr. Ryan Chen Wing from Singapore. And Commissioner Mr. Austin from Myanmar. และลำดับต่อไปขอเชิญทุกท่านในที่นี้ยืนตรงเพื่อเคารพเพลงชาติ Please stand for national anthem. ไม่พลาดเอกราชจะไม่ให้ใครคงทิ้งสละเลือดทุกอย่างเป็นชาติบริเวณพลังประเทศจะไทยก็เป็นปีใสชโยเอาละค่ะและเดี๋ยวเราจะทำการวอร์มในกันในอีก3นาทีด้วยกัน และทุกท่านในที่นี้ค่ะก็จะได้พบกับเกมการแข่งขันระหว่างทีมไทยทั้ง2ทีมนะคะเรียกได้ว่าความสนุกสนานกำลังจะเกิดขึ้นในอีกไม่กี่อึดใจนี้นะคะก็อดใจรออีกสักครู่เดียวค่ะ
So we got to see a couple of new faces here on the Mono Vampire squad. We got to saw number 8, Slan Yu In Mung. He's a point guard. Point guard who's half Thai.
He's full Thai, former Bangkok Cobras. He's from Los Angeles. Played high school basketball.
He has yet to play a game in the ABL with this season with the Mono Vampires, but he's been going around with the team a lot, doing a lot of coordinating with the teammates to get everyone on the same picture, especially with the imports. So he's always played a big role in the team, and finally we might get to see him play in this game today. Also, another familiar face is Singh Chanachon Glahan. He just recently came back from his religious duties as a monk. But we're going to see the lineup today. We got Ratnek Kertiwa, Foylan Bagyan, Anthony McLean, Mike Fay, and Rong Panapilom Wilai Chai, arguably their best starting five right now at this moment. They're pretty much settled with this one. They, in the recent game, Radek Kratiwa had 18 points off a barrage of three-point shots. For High Tech Bangkok City, we have Wutipong Dasom, Tyler Lam, Freddie Goldstein, Chris Charles, and Steve Thomas. Also their main lineup. You see there, Steven Demon Thomas, that nickname.
That nickname.
That's you. It's stuck with him right now because of you. But yeah, that's a pretty good nickname for him, for a guy that always shows his fire and passion on the courts. And both teams are just letting it out in their shoot-arounds for the coaches go and make their final adjustments here. Got a pretty good crowd for the Thais. Both Thai teams drawing both fans from both teams. Crowds are packed here, Pete.
You know, DK, speaking of Sao Inmung, you know, I think, in my opinion, he belongs on the team. He needs to be in the 12-man roster. Sometimes when you need that energy, that fire, especially defensive energy, he brings a lot of that to the game.
Yeah, and Sal's a really energetic player. If you've been able to see him in the practice sessions of the Mono Vampires, he's always the one who's talking.
Yeah.
Everyone up, getting everyone fired.
Yep, very vocal.
Yeah, very vocal player. It's going to be integral to the game today. Mono Vampires are going to be in white, and the High Tech Bangkok City are going to be in their usual green. As we mentioned, this is going to be the Mono Vampires' third home game here at Chulalongkorn University Sports Complex. Just make sure you get to the right stadium. You can go by the BTS station at National Stadium or the MRT station at Samyan. Just make sure you get to the right stadium here. A funny story, I just recently came back from the Philippines for the game against the Saigon Heat and the Philippines MX3 Kings. They had a problem with getting the stadium right, and they were going to go to a PBA game. In the end, they went to the wrong stadium, and they missed the game altogether. So don't make that same mistake.
Wow, so they went to the wrong stadium.
Yep, they went to the wrong stadium. They must have been pretty confused why no one was there.
And all right, you heard the bell. They're on the floor. The Battle of Thailand.
Everyone seems focused and ready to bring on the blood.
This is more than just the standings.
This is a grudge match. This is what they're paying for, bragging rights until their next game. In this series, High Tech have already won their first two home games. So Mono Vampires want to get one back. There's the tip-off. But then Bagyan starts off with the ball here. Crowds get noisy. Faye gets his first touch against Chris Charles, tries to drag him out of the zone. See what they can come up with in this first possession. Faye aggressive from the start. And immediately makes the 2 points, making his presence shown. Mono Vampires pressuring the ball early. Northern Bagyan on Freddie Goldstein there. We have Radekra Tiwa on Tyler Lam. Tyler Lam makes an aggressive drive, but gets blocked. And he gets the put back in.
Faye looks really comfortable going against Charles and Thomas here.
Faye loves playing against High Tech, though. He's been always a thorn in their bush. Faye gets the basket, but doesn't get there. And then with the pull-up three, doesn't make it this time. Tyler Lam is a pretty good three-point shooter, but maybe the rest has gotten to him. A lot of rust here to get off. Radek with a three-point shot. No one's hitting the long ball right now. And Wutipong Dasom brings the ball up. We're going to see High Tech set it up a little bit. Freddie Goldstein, arguably one of the best point guards in the league right now, also misses a three-point shot. What do you think about Freddie Goldstein's game right now, Pete?
You know, we've seen what he can do. He can definitely catch on fire. He's a very high-skilled player, very strong defender. But at the same time, he has to stay disciplined and you know, do what's right for the team to win. So overall, he's an A-plus player.
Yeah, good point. Good point about the discipline, though. He's been looking really good in the first half of the season in the ABL. Steve Thomas gets the ball in the post. team struggling to find the basket right now. It's a 2-2 game, 2 minutes in.
Everyone's rushing right now. Need to slow it down on both sides.
Everyone might be getting a little bit emotional. Mike Fay again with a two-point shot. That's what the manager, Abichok Sakho, was talking about. Someone hit those mid-range shots.
He looks very comfortable right now.
Always well is playing against high-tech Bangkok City. Since his day with the Nakhon Mad Goats or with Mono 2, he's always been someone that high-tech have found a bit uncomfortable to play with. See if high-tech Bangkok City can get some offensive flow here. Anthony McLean has been doing well anticipating the drives from Freddie Goldstein and Tyler Lamb here. He's already gotten two blocks. One of the best shot blockers in the ABL right now. Here is another one of the best shot blockers, Chris Charles, getting inside. Can't make the basket. It rolls around. Finally, the Mono Vampires get the ball. Orlin Baguion pushing the ball up. Very good point guard here for Orlin Baguion. Good at setting up players, but this time he takes his own. Playing with the offensive rebound.
Goldstein, high pressure defense.
Goldstein's a really good defender. Michael Fay finally cools off there, but Rockman gets the ball somehow, draws the foul.
Isn't that what he does?
That's what he always does. Somehow gets there.
Can't blink on a bomb, you know?
Quick player, strong player. He's always going to get there somehow.
True veteran, knows how to get to the line.
Yep. Getting to the line is a really crucial part of any offense. No one is better than that in Thailand than Rongpan. And he misses one free throw though, but Mono Vampires take a 3-point lead. Goldstein's gonna set it up again, getting it to Chris Thomas down low. Goldstein takes the three, still off their mark. Anthony McLean with another rebound.
Baguion moving up the ball to J.O. J.O. squaring up against Lamb.
J.O. still unable to hit a three-point shot in this game, but he hit plenty of them in their last game against Singapore. Gonna have to set up their offensive
7 seconds.
Quickly. And takes a long three. Still no one hitting those threes. Fast break, Thailand gets the basket. Misses the floater. Charles struggling to score inside.
The presence of Fay, TK.
That's what's going on. Charles is no small guy, 7'1", but he's going up someone his size, and that's affected it early on. Here's again with a mid-range shot. He's cooling off a lot right now. Maybe they want to look into another offensive option. Pretty close, he goes all the way. Doesn't finish anyway. Tech has found a lid on the rim right now, unable to score anything at this point. Still a low scoring affair here, 5-4.
It's a very long game though. It's gonna be tough for Mono in some sense.
Yeah.
If the two bad boys start running a little bit for High Tech.
Sure. And the wrong pun with a wild drive there, and he goes out. Ball goes out of bounds. Rongpan looking for a call there, doesn't get it. Seems like Wutipong Dasa was rattled up a little bit, and there's some commotion here on the court. You're not seeing it on screen, but emotions flying early here in the game. But the thing for High Tech right now that you want to see is not that, obviously. You don't want to see a turnover like that. That's a little bit of a mental breakdown here. But right now, the focus for High Tech should be focus on getting back into the game. They've been 20 days away from being in competitive basketball. They just want to get into the groove, don't force anything, and just really learn how these Mono Vampires are going to play.
You know, with High Tech, the problem with High Tech sometimes is they're so talented individually, TK.
Yeah.
So it's definitely a task for the coach to get these guys together.
Sure.
If you look at a team like KL, they are a very well-oiled machine.
Yeah.
And that's, yeah, and that's why they're able to produce like the way they're producing right now, actually. As Steve, the Demon, gets an easy one in the rim.
Nice pass there from Chris Charles. Nice run offense there from High-Tech Bangkok City, and that's what you want to see from that. Moto Vampire is going to attack right back. Foy with a three-point shot, and it goes in. Can't leave Foy open either, but you can't let him penetrate and go out for that kickoff shot. Kickoff pass. Moto Vampire is looking comfortable here early in the game. I think Bangkok City to retaliate. And a veteran move there to get the foul on Freddie Goldstein. It's called for a push-off.
Remember what I said last game we were here, TK, about Bagyon's defense?
Yeah.
He really knows how to play
like
defense in the most awkward and maybe in the floor, would we call it annoying?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah, he definitely has a really good annoying defense that he knows how to get in that spot.
Yeah, that's how he's stayed on the court all these years, already in his mid-30s, but still strong, still a smart player. That's why he's still on the field. Very good player. And we've yet to even see his passes here in this game already, and he's made a lot of impact on the scoring and the defense.
You know, I think with the new coaching staff, I think they're kind of encouraging to say, Floyd, you know, come off the screen and shoot. You know, take a couple of those shots, see where it is, and then go from there. So I think that's what he's doing right now, and it's going in.
So if you must know, this is not the only ABL game we have today. We also have a game between the KL Dragons and the Saigon Heat, who should be ending up soon. The score at halftime was 55-21 in the advantage of the KL Dragons. And that's a result that the Mono Vampires want to see if they're going to stay in playoff contention. They don't want the Heat getting any steam. They want to keep them close. And imagine if the Saigon Heat lose today and the Mono Vampires are able to pull off a win here. They're still very much in the playoff run. Both teams still staying with the same lineup. No substitutions yet. Cleaning up the floor a little bit here.
Slow start for both Freddie Goldstein and Tyler Lamb a little bit.
Yep, no one's getting easy scores. None of their shots are falling right now, but like you said, 20 days away from playing competitive basketball. You just have to let it fly a little bit. Maybe get into the rhythm later on. Jago with the ball here, drives inside. Driving in, gets inside. Good move, and the three-point play and chance here. Like you said, veterans get to the line.
Between Dasom and Thomas.
Lohan being an offensive force early in the game here. He misses another free throw. In a tight game, free throws are going to be crucial. They can't let that hang on their head. Running the offense a bit, we're seeing Foy and Bagyon play on Dasom. Might want to look to exploit that height advantage. Gets the drive inside, and it's a traveling violation. Dasom not getting things his way early in this game.
Got to
learn to step up from those falls. High double screen here. Portland Bagyon with the three again. He doesn't make it this time. And Steve Thomas ends up with the rebound.
Here comes Lamb.
Lamb with a nice shifty move. Still can't finish on his side. And High Tech ball.
Today's going to be one of those games for High Tech where whoever's penetrating, they got to start hitting shots. Why? Because Charles and Thomas is not going to be able to clean up for them as much as they used to it, you know?
Yeah, 2 7-footers down low in there. That's not easy to get these down low. Nice pass from Steve Thomas to the top, moving.
Good cut by Dasom.
Good cut, and he finishes it off. But nice recognition, nice cut. good playing all together. Ball grabbing a little bit.
Turnover.
Nice
behind
pass
the back.
From Freddie Goldstein. Quick hands from Foyt and Bagyan to knock away the potential highlight play. And we're going to see a substitution there. They're going to bring out Foyt and bring in Kanat Samerjai, the Thai point guard. Been playing quite well in the ABL so far. But his minutes have been up and down, and body's going down.
Charles long two, no good. McClain.
McClain grabbing a lot of rebounds early. Doing the dirty work. Rohan going all inside again. And he loses the ball this time. Jerome's drive has been pretty much 50-50 up to this point. He's able to get the foul, but sometimes it's just too wild. The ball goes out of bounds. Freddie Goldstein juggling around there and still unable to finish. But Chris Charles gets it somehow and finishes it with a dunk. They're still managing to keep it close, but you don't really like what you're seeing from the high tank offense early on. They've been struggling to get baskets.
McClain
goes inside.
It's going to be a battle for McClain and Thomas inside. Starting to get scuffy.
Nice passing here from High Tech Bangkok City. The Bongpan blocks Dasom. Som goes again. Nice fake. And he finishes. Good hustle there from Wutipong Dasom. Not giving up after he got blocked. And he was rewarded with the pass inside again.
Good energy from Goldstein hitting the ball.
Yep. Now both teams 12-2 in the advantage of High Tech. Nice pass from Fei. Merjai couldn't handle it. And High Tech with a fast play again. Lamb.
What a triple.
Right in the face of another three-point shooter, Radek Kratiwa. I'm expecting Radek to go straight at him again on this offensive play if he gets the ball.
Yep.
There's a screen from McClain. Fei gets attacked immediately by Chris Charles.
Chris Charles realizes right away that was not a smart foul.
So they're going to get a timeout to talk it over a little bit. But that was High Tech's fourth foul already in this quarter. And that's going to be something to look at. They have some depth inside with Sukhdev Gogar and Denai Kongkum, but going up against the twin hours, the twin 7-foot towers of Anthony McClain and Mike Fei, you just have to keep those fouls down low from Chris Charles and Stephen Thomas if you're High Tech.
A real twin tower. Over 7 foot. But you know, they got veteran players on the High Tech bench.
Yeah.
Atapon, you know, he's been in the ABL since day one. So he's definitely a high energy player coming off the bench. High Tech can definitely go on fire like they just did just now. So Mono's got to keep doing what they plan to do. And they had a good start. They have to stop the green from running.
Sure. The transition defense is looking a little bit better from the green. But they need to pump it up more if they want to go away from it here.
I think for Mono Vampires on offense, it's a really good idea to go into Fei in the high post and then isolate him, because one-on-one, I think Fei has a really nice offensive game.
That's a good idea. But I'm also not liking the lack of touches that Anthony McClain has been getting inside, down low in the post. I know that Steve Thomas has been playing good defense, but you just got to give him some of the touches for the defensive players.
60-40 at least, you know?
Yeah.
Can't just let him stand around and do nothing.
The wrong punt, getting the ball again. Going for the three, misses it.
That was poor ball movement by Amano.
Yep, here's the transition offense we were talking about. The Mono Vampires have got to stop that. You can't get the two bad boys, Freddie Goldstein and Tyler Lamb, of going full steam there. Nice pass from Goldstein, nice finish from Lamb. That's something you got to watch out for. Kurtiwa gets the ball. Still has yet to take another shot after that first miss. Well, then Bagyan takes another three. Still can't make it. And it's Mono Vampire ball.
I'm starting to like this Goldstein Bagyan matchup. Former teammates in 2012 for the Thailand Open.
So they pretty much know each other.
They know each other very well.
Another fast break here. Dasan goes all the way for the dunk. Team owner Nippon Shaolin Bontien likes that. He stands up in celebration. He's liking what he sees from his team early on, but the Mono Vampires have got to just stay in there. It's only the first quarter. Long way to go.
Here we go, McLean.
Here's the inside touches by McLean. Spacing up the zone. Foy for the three. Barely misses in and out. And it's still Mono Vampire ball with 23 seconds left on the game clock and 5 seconds left on the shot clock.
They got to move the ball quicker. I mean, Biggie, he's just not used to having teammates like Faye now. So, and you gotta move the ball because Steve's not going to let you bang in there like that.
Sure.
So I think the second option, when he gets the ball once, give it back, get it again a little bit lower, and go up right away.
Yep, good point, Pete.
He can't hold on and think about it.
Yeah.
Steve is, you know, obviously he's the legend of this league. He's been in many situations. He's not going to let you stand and push him in.
Yeah, he knows what to do. So the shot clock up to 11 after adjustments. Faye gets the ball here. Nice pass to Bagyan. Nice pass to Raddak, who misses the three. Freddie Goldstein with the ball again. In transition. Tyler Lim from the corner. And another dead eye shot. High Tech Bangkok City going up huge here. 14-0 run against the Mono Vampires for the Bagyan. Ends the quarter. Misses the half-court shot. This is not the start that the Mono Vampires envisioned going into the third home game of the season. What do you think about the first quarter, Pete?
Well, Mono Vampires came out with a really impressive start, in my opinion. But like we said, having two heavy twin towers in this situation, not discrediting them. They're both very skilled, very good players. But it's going to be tough going against High Tech. I mean, every time you turn around, they're running, and you're going against three, not two, not just the bad boys, but also Chris Charles, you know? So wait and see second quarter. Maybe they'll make changes.
Sure. Are down by 12 in their home court here, and they're going to be High Tech's going to be inbounding the ball.
I'd like to see better ball movement for Mono Vampires. I want to see a better game.
Good point. It's been pretty much the same story here for Mono Vampires from against the Singapore Swingers. They got down in a big hole early on from fast break points.
Great pass, Goldstein.
Getting inside.
Clock.
Twin Towers doing their damage here, blocking everything inside down low. High Tech just struggling to finish anything down there.
Wagyong can barely sit down looking in from the sideline after Goldstein just did that.
6 seconds left on the shot clock and a turnover. Submergei running off. Tyler Lam. He's going to get a foul there for pushing off Nathagarn Mungun, who was running in his way. Should be a foul on the floor. So Mono Vampire is going to inbound the ball. Kyle Lamb's got to watch out for those. Right there, Curtis. Michael Fay from mid-range. And he ices it again.
That's the thing about Fay. He has a lot of experience. If you look at his resume, he's battle-tested.
Yeah. UCLA, Los Angeles Defenders in the D-League. He's been places, and he knows how to play high level.
CBA.
Steve Thomas unable to reply with his own mid-range shot, and the Mono Vampires get a chance again. So that mid-range jumper from Michael Fay broke the 14-0 run finally.
Yep, they got to get the ball to him.
Yep.
And work around him, in my opinion.
Samurjai with a pull-up, doesn't make it, but Mono Vampires get the offensive rebound. Here we go again, setting it up. Nattegaard goes straight to the basket. Doesn't make it. Ball goes on the rim, and Charles ends up with the ball. Freddie Goldstein running it up quickly. Turns the ball over again. Diamond Wood going all the way, but he gets Michael Fay on the fast break for the dunk. Timeout called by High Tech. Bangkok City to stop the bleeding. Michael Fay has come up huge for the Mono Vampires in this game. Nice timeout there called by Coach Jing Ruiz, though. He knew his team needed to settle down a little bit after two very bad turnovers.
That was definitely a better session for Mono Vampires there. They have to be patient on their shooting. Sure. I know that Rutdate is looking to shoot, but you gotta go to the right person.
Right now, that person is Michael Fay right now. He's on fire.
Definitely. Definitely.
Hitting almost everything in mid-range. And right there with the athletic dunk on the fast break. It's got to be encouraging for the Mono Vampire to see that Michael Fay is running up and down again. He's been bugged with a couple of injuries recently, but to see him dunk like that, you've got to just throw those worries away.
It's good to see also, you know, Mono Vampire's defense has gotten better. And you saw a couple blocks there by both Fay and McLean, and it shows that half-court game they can battle.
Yeah.
And now they just have to do it the same way on the other end, half-court offense, and at least be able to convert and get shots 50-50, you know, on offensive half-court game rather than turning the ball over.
Yeah.
So if they can just get a 50-50 every time, and just like the way High Tech is doing right now. But High Tech's running. Of course, they're a running, more running team.
What they do.
Yep. Sanacho Ngaha, number 91.
Yep.
Entered for Mono Vampire.
Back into the court. Nakor Chai Sanuk, also in the court for High Tech Bangkok City. For Wutsupong Daso. Jimmy Thomas gets the ball out far here. So, nice pass for Bischoff. Again, McLean with the block. They haven't been letting anything go in the half-court offense. Cameron Woods goes all the way with Steve.
Oh.
Steve Thomas says, I can do that too.
Similar story, huh?
Freddie Goldstein with a nice pass to Chris Charles, but draws the foul on the floor. Both teams going at each other. Not letting an inch of space. Setting up away from the basket again. And then gets the ball. Mid-range jumper way off, but foul's going to be called on Sanachon Glaha. Seems like the ref deemed him going at Tyler Lamb a little bit too dangerously. Still called for the foul.
I think he got hit in the groin just now.
Oh.
that's not what they put him in for.
Hopefully not. And Thailand with two free throws out of that. Holmley makes the first free throw, his first in the game. Hitech have not been at the line that much today as compared to Mono. Makes them both.
Tyler Lamb, also former UCLA, just like Michael Fay.
Good point, Pete.
Former Bruins. They just had the Russell Westbrook day recently.
So Westbrook went on fire today. Michael Fay with going inside, drops the pass out. The Vampires get the ball again. The lineup they have right now, the Mono Vampires have right now, Boon, Samer Jai, Chanachon. It's not going to be one that spaces out a lot, but that's what they want. They want the inside play there, and they get Anthony McLean.
That was a good pass to McLean there.
Good pass. I think Bangkok City have got to figure out their offense in the half court. Haven't been able to score much from there. Nakorn with a three. Still can't make it. Mike Fay with the rebound. And they have the numbers here on offense. Summerjai goes straight at the basket. Nice drop pass. Foul on Stephen Thomas.
I'm liking it. I'm like what Mono's doing, being aggressive.
Yep.
Take it to their chest.
Yep.
Show them how bad you want it. They got two big twin towers. They got to bring it in there, put it up in the rim so they can clean it up.
Good point. That's Stephen Thomas's first foul. So still in safe territory right now. Thing goes to the line, not a really good free throw shooter, but he gets his sometimes. Pierre Pompirun is making his way onto the court for Tyler Lamb, who's going to get a breather to his justice shot a little bit.
I think that was a pretty nice adjustment on the Mono's coach, Coach Joe, by putting in two point guards. Definitely moving the ball well. And also, there are three local players who are on for Vampires right now, all played in the same national team, so they're very familiar with each other.
With the second makes it this time. Cut the lead down to 7 points. Cut the lead down to 7 points. There you go. So I think Bangkok City in a bit of a struggle here early in the second quarter. Anything inside, Steve Thomas still struggling. Nice drop pass to Chris Charles, but a lot of pressure inside with the steal. Summerjai goes to the basket, draws the foul again.
Give Summerjai credit. He's being very aggressive, not shying away.
Yeah, despite being the smallest player on the court right now.
This is the way Mono Vampires have to play the whole game if they want to play fast. And, on a half-court game, you know, you got two options. So just keep doing that. Limit the far shooting. Shouldn't be shooting too many threes.
So the guy with a chance to cut it down to five. Doesn't make it, so they're still down by six. But aggressive. Yeah, Summerjai been over here. Ooh, Freddy goes to trying to shake him loose. That inside defense, McLean's just always in the face. There's an offensive rebound though. McCord with a mid-range shot.
Taro!
And the tip back. Put back by Chris Charles. Finally finding a seam in that inside game. What a dunk.
Watch ahead.
Watch out, Twin Towers. Not the only tall people here. Mike Fay, nice pass. Nice drop pass to Chanachon.
Nice move, nice pass.
Nice ball movement. You got three very good, unselfish players here. And the locals on the perimeter. And they're moving the ball really well, as you mentioned.
Yep.
A foul is called on Chris Charles. Illegal screen. Oh, Summerjai doing a lot of damage here, collecting the fouls from the Hitech Bangkok City players. That's going to be Chris Charles' second foul. Coach Jing Ruiz is going to bring Freddie Goldstein back to the bench. Going to bring in kind of what the Valko. Change of pace here a little bit. Summerjai still going straight at the Hitech Bangkok City defense. Anthony was playing with a nice move.
Good move. No foul
fade
call.
Away.
McLean giving Thomas some moves here.
Yep. Nice beam shake there. Court open for three.
Oh, no good.
Still doesn't make it. Kind of turn with the rebound. Pushes it up.
Good take by Klahan. Oh, Mono Vampire is coming back.
Mono Vampire just keeps staying aggressive like this. They're going to go away with it. Only 4 points halfway into the second quarter here for High Tech Bangkok City.
Great defense, team defense by Mono Vampires getting the ball back.
Great defense, great transition offense. This is what the Mono Vampires want to see. Talk about a tale of two quarters here. Senatron again.
Klahan again.
Coming back out of nowhere.
He said, I was in the temple studying basketball.
A new way to play for Senatron Klahan. All the way down from 12 points, they're only down by two now.
This is what I want to see, a good game. Battle of Thailand.
Yes, Battle of Thailand. Tale of two quarters right now. High Tech Bangkok City went up by 12 in the first quarter off a run of fast breaks. Right now, Mona Vampire is giving a taste of their own medicine, running up straight in their faces and finishing. Got a lot of adjustment to do here for Coach Jing Ruiz. I expect that the environment in the Mona Vampire's bench right now has got to be a bit jolly. They're liking what they see, but until they get that lead, they can't rest.
And I think the environment in the High Tech bench is not jolly right now.
Coach Jing should not like anything he saw there.
And let's give a shout out to our sponsors, of course, the ABL. We got Air Asia, the official sponsor, official airline sponsor of the ABL.
We got Li Ning, the official basketball sponsor for the ABL. And you have McDavid, the official compression wear sponsor for every team. High Tech's gonna come away inbounding the ball after this run. Gonna see some changes, a lot of changes for the Mono Vampires actually. Bringing Chittipon Norwayrod and Sorot Suntan Siri. Interesting move to see if they can keep up that tempo that they've built up. And what gets into the corner, Steve Thomas down low, nice pass to Piavong Virun. Misses the shot. Mono Vampires have a chance to tire, take the lead here. That was pretty good ball movement there from High Tech Bangkok City, just unable to finish it.
One point I may add for this game is if the game is close, it's going to come down to who wins the rebounding game.
Yeah, good point.
That's if the game is close.
Another foul there on High Tech Bangkok City. Again, Mono Vampire is going aggressive. Now they're in the penalty. Galahan going for two free throws. He has 6 points right now. Misses the first one. They've missed a lot of free throws here, and they could be hurting from it.
You know who I'd like to see for High Tech, TK?
Who do you mean, Pete?
I think a good player for High Tech to bring in is Danai Kong Fu, as he's a very strong offensive player. And they kind of need that right now out of a local.
Sure. Maybe they want to give some rest to Steve Thomas and Chris Charles.
Oh, he can play as a three. You know, offensively, he knows where to shoot. He's not going to shoot where he's not uncomfortable.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, where he's uncomfortable, I mean. So you don't have to worry about the offensive end for Danai Kong Kung, but, you know, he can also definitely defend a three.
Good point.
For High Tech.
Quick hands.
Yeah.
Quick feet. Chris Charles now gets the foul, and High Tech goes to the free throw line.
Knock on Dyson Nook number 30 for High Tech hasn't really been producing points right now, and they have also another shooter, Pyroon, number 13, the team captain.
Uh-huh.
So, I mean, I'd like to see them put Danai in there, or Atapon.
Yeah, change up the feel of the perimeter.
You need a leader aggressor,
yeah.
Just like how Samojai just did for Mono.
Yeah. Very good point. Bay here looks the three but doesn't take it. Lahan getting aggressive but doesn't draw the foul this time. Nice pass on the fast break. McGord.
Oh, not high enough.
Bad pass there from McGord.
Timber.
Ball is going somewhere. Finally gets the foul. So High Tech going aggressive as well here, going back and forth at each other. But McGord.
Uh-oh. We have a Faye down low to get up. And he gets back up.
Walking. Okay. So that's good.
You'd think the teammate would be slow getting up. Chopper, number seven.
he took a hard hit. More changes for the Mono Vampires here. Durongpan coming back in. Raddeg as well. Chopper and Singh is going out. Oh. Free throw woes for both teams here. High Tech has missed three straight.
Wrong Dyson Nuke here, number 30. He woke up on the wrong side of bed today. He usually doesn't miss like this.
He misses two straight. Uncharacteristic free throw shooting here from the front Dyson Nuke. Nice defense here from Kanawat on the youngster, Sorod. Nice pressure. But he breaks free somehow. Gets a good pass to Anthony McLean.
McLean, four greens around him, no foul call.
No whistle called there after all that impact contact. Kanawat sizing up the Durongpan there. Nice pass inside to Steve Thomas for the hook shot. Misses completely. They can't buy a basket at all right now. High Tech, Bangkok City, only 4 points. Durongpan going almost all the way, but another bad pass.
Lofty plays for both sides.
Refs are silent here.
Three.
Misses still. Game has not stopped at all, and Motor Vampire suddenly decide to take it slow here.
I like that Mono Vampires are being aggressive, but don't be over-aggressive.
Yeah. And I don't know what called for a foul on the long time there. Off the ball. He's going to get the long time to the line.
As you see, the bad boys coming back in. Patented nickname for me again. And Ruben Dassel.
Going back to their starting lineup. Mono Vampire is getting a chance to finally take the lead here, but if your coach Jing Rees, the 4 points they have scored in this second quarter has got to be very worrying. They haven't been able to buy a basket at all. They have let the Mono Vampires come back into the game.
Oh.
Neither team can buy a free throw at all right now. Both teams might have combined it for at least 6 or 7 straight missed free throws. Low scoring affair here in the game in deep Bangkok here.
As you've seen just now before the two ASEAN imports or the Thai Am come in.
Yep.
And you see just pure Thais playing against each other. It turns into a Muay Thai match. Body flying.
Contact everywhere. Fitzgerald brings the ball up itself. Ooh. Gets Faye with a crossover.
Oh.
And he finishes. Chris Charles channeling his Lamar Odom going point guard on Michael Faye there. What a move.
Have it your way, Chris Charles said.
Air ball there. Wudipong Dasso doesn't get it. Dorot takes a three. Ball goes up and can't make it.
Low scene.
Still pushing it back up. This is the tempo they were playing at the first quarter.
Man for three, no good.
Still no good here. 3-point shot, not falling for anyone today. Steven Thomas with a quick hand somehow gets away with the ball. Tyler Lamb drops it to Dasom and they're going to set it up in the half court again. Tyler Lamb there was thinking for a second of going at Anthony McLean, but after a couple of bucks, I don't think so.
You gotta think twice when you see Biggie.
Yep.
That's a big boy.
Big boy, Biggie. And we're gonna see Froylan Bagyan coming back into the game. So both teams are back to their starting lineup here to finish off the first half. A minute and a half left to go. again with all the misses and the free throws piling up here.
What is going on with the free throws today? And it's not just one side, huh?
Both sides not able to get anything from the line. Finally, Dasol makes one. Puts Hitech Bangkok City up by three.
We've barely seen any points this second quarter, TK.
Yeah, low score here.
Good game so far. We're here at Chula Longkorn University. Bangkok City.
Bit hot, but good landing nonetheless. Nice steal there from Freddy, just jumping out of the air.
Right in his hand.
Pushes it. Nice pass. Dasol
with
the alley-oop.
Good lob, Freddy Goldstein.
How did he see that? That was pure communication, pure familiarity from Hitech Bangkok City. Just throw up the ball and someone's going to get it.
Point guard skills right there. Faye for three.
Doesn't make it. And Hitech Bangkok City going over the run again. Tyler Lamb trying to find his way. Foul on Bagyon. This is the story we were seeing at the tail end of the first quarter. Hitech Bangkok City running again.
Bagyon making a smart decision to foul, but they are in the penalty.
Look at the way the free throws are going. Bagyon might have made a very good decision there. Even the sharpshooting Tyler Lamb is starting to miss. See if he can make the second one here. And he does. 4-point lead for, 6-point lead for Hitech Bangkok City. 40 seconds left in the first half. See who ends up in the lead here. Up.
Bagyon holding on to the ball.
Nice pass to McLean, but there's a stepping out of bounds there. Hitech gets the ball. But the changes we've seen once Bagyon has come on the floor is the aggressiveness has suddenly become a little bit passive. On the Mono Vampire from what we've seen early in the second quarter.
Yeah, one thing you don't want to do if you're Mono Vampires right now is hold on to the ball too long.
Yep. 7 seconds left. Freddie Goldstein wants to create something.
Great move by Freddie Goldstein.
Hitech ends with a run. Hitech ends the first half with a 6-0 run. They now hold on to an 8-point lead in this first half of this low-scoring affair between Hitech Bangkok City and Mono Vampires in the Bangkok City Brawl.
You are watching the ASEAN Basketball League
So, we're seeing the stats here from the first First half, miserable shooting from both teams. 30.3% only for the Mono Vampire.
You're lucky winner นะคะและผู้โชคดีทั้งสองท่านค่ะได้รับเสื้อนะคะจาก Mono Vampire ง่ายๆนะคะเพียงแค่ซื้อนะคะตัวเข้าชมเกมการแข่งขันระหว่างทีม Mono Vampire และเปิดบ้านต้อนรับคู่ต่อสู้นะคะง่ายๆแบบนี้เลยนะคะรับไปเลยค่ะของรางวัลของเราและเพื่อไม่การเสียเวลานะคะเราจะขอเชิญตัวแทนน้องๆนะคะเนื่องจากวันนี้ค่ะเป็นวันเด็กแห่งชาตินะคะเราจะมีการร่วมเล่นเกมนะคะจากน้องๆ นะคะเยาวชนของเราค่ะขอเชิญน้องบอสน้องเลนะคะน้องรีและน้องเชอร์นิกค่ะเสร็จก่อนคนนั้นก็จะได้เป็นผู้ชนะนั่นเองค่ะเอาเลยค่ะเดี๋ยวเราแบ่งฝั่งกันก่อนไหมเดี๋ยวหนูโอเคถ้าพร้อมแล้วนะคะเริ่มค่ะเย้เย้เย้เย้มาเป็นกำลังใจนะคะให้น้องของเราโอ้โหยังไงยังไงยังไงเอาให้ลงให้ลงวู้กลับมาลูกถอดรองเท้าได้เลยลูกนะระวังหัวแตกนะคะระวังมือหัวแตกนะคะเสร็จแล้วยังไงไปอีกฝั่งแล้วแล้วซีซีซียังไงโอ้โหได้รับรางวัลไปแล้วนะคะผู้ชนะของเราแต่น้องเรย์ของเรานะคะเรียกว่าสปิริตแรงกล้าเหลือเกินนะคะเนื่องจากวันนี้นะคะความสามารถของเราได้ขอเสียงปรบมือให้เด็กๆทั้ง4คนด้วยค่ะโอ้โหหายใจหายคอแทบไม่ทันนะคะดิฉันเหมือนเป็นแร็ปเปอร์คนหนึ่งเลยนะคะเอาละค่ะและผู้โชคดีของเรานะคะก เอาละค่ะก็พักกันสักครู่เดียวนะคะและกลับมาพบกับเกมการแข่งขันกันได้ใหม่ในควอเตอร์ที่3ค่ะ
What we got to see from the first half of that game, we didn't get to see much offense, but saw a lot of aggressiveness for both teams going at each other. What do you think about that first half, Pete?
Well, both teams have not played the way that they wanted to, of course, due to the heavy defense from both teams. A lot has to do with both teams having twin towers, but they're both getting points in different ways. Of course, High Tech more in transition. They got three strong runners, and with Mono, they've kind of just been grinding, getting their points from the grind out and a strong offensive individual play from Michael Fay. So my second half prediction for this game is going to be one of those, a lot of contact for sure in the second half. It's going to be very physical. Yeah. And I'm waiting to see that. That's what I like to see.
Yeah. Just hope that the refs can keep it under control. We don't want to see anything get out of line here.
Of course.
Yeah, just good contact. Basketball is a contact sport after all. The first half, as you mentioned, we saw Michael Fay scoring 9 points for the Mono Vampires off 4 of 8 shooting. But their leading scorer was Anthony McLean, who had 11 points off a lot of free throws.
Wow. It didn't seem like he scored that much, but
sorry. Anthony McLean had just 3 points. Oh. That was wrong column on the table there. My bad. But for the High Tech Bangkok City side, we saw 15 points from Tyler Lamb to lead it all, but an uncharacteristic 0 points from Freddie Goldstein, who has been shooting only 0-for-6.
But he'll get his points. From the games I've seen him, he can catch fire immediately. So, and he could score points in spurts. So, I think he's trying to control himself and stay under the coach's saying and distribute the ball.
But despite his scoring woes, he's been able to distribute 6 assists for High Tech Bangkok City, the most of any player in this game already. And it's actually only 1 assist below the Mono Vampires' total of 7.
Oh wow!
Yeah, but both teams shooting very poorly, only around 30%. But as you said, the defense has been fantastic for both teams with those two twin towers. Teams have been struggling to score. But we're going to see if any of the coaches are able to figure that out during that halftime break. Mono Vampire set up on the court already. And here comes High Tech Bangkok City. Another point, High Tech has been grabbing 9 offensive rebounds already. That is a huge point. And that was one of the concerns of the Mono Vampires against Singapore Slingers in late game situations where they gave up 2 offensive rebounds in that last play that set up Desmond O for the dagger 3. If this keeps on going, it's not going to be good for the Moto Vampires with those two twin towers. The perimeter defense have got to place a body on those outside players to protect the high-tech Bangkok City from getting extra possessions. Seems to be setting up a little bit slow here, but the lineups are going to be for high-tech Bangkok City, the same starting lineup. Tyler Lair, Freddie Goldstein, Steve Thomas, Wuti Pong Dasom, and Chris Charles. Bench there. Getting a little bit fun with the camera. The Mono Vampires are going to have Brennan Bakian, Radek Kratiwa, Jerome Pan, Apiro Milai Chai, and their two twin towers, Anthony McLean and Mike Fay, still on the court. None of the world imports have gotten a break. And if the game is this close, we really don't expect them to either.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
I don't think Michael Fay and Anthony McLean, Chris Charles, and Steve Thomas are getting a break this game.
So that's going to be a lot to look out for. If any of them get into foul trouble, that's going to be huge. But then again, both teams have good locals to bring in. So get Golgar for High Tech and Chaiwat Kedam from Mono Vampires, who can produce enough minutes for these guys to get breathers if the chance comes.
As you see, the Mono Vampires mascot having fun with the fans. This is the Nepal national team, is that right, TK?
Yep, the Nepal national team, national basketball team, are in town in Bangkok for a couple of days, and a good timing for them to be able to come and watch this Bangkok City brawl rivalry between both teams. We hope that they enjoy this game as much as we are enjoying it.
And for the Nepalese fans who are watching their national basketball team here, we'd like to give a shout out to them and thank you for coming to support the ABO.
Yep. The game should be underway soon. Mono Vampires is going to inbound the ball. Tyler Lim, the last guy making it onto the court there. Here we go. Second half of Mono Vampires versus High Tech Bangkok City. And instant turnover by the Mono Vampires. High Tech Bangkok City start off with their first offensive position. Freddie Goldstein looking to start up. There you go. There's the scoring that Freddie Goldstein was eventually going to get. He didn't wait long for that feat.
Oh, he's the type of player, you know, you can give him a nickname, Baby Iverson. He can shoot all day if he wants to.
Yeah.
But I think he's just picking and choosing, and that was definitely a cakewalk in the park, that one right there.
And a steal there, lazy passing. Radek Kratiwa passes it back to Ferdinand Bagan, sets it up again. Nice pass all the way to Kratiwa for three. Kratiwa finally gets on the board with a three-point shot. That could spark something for the Mono Vampires. And again.
Oh, would have been something he made that
move. That was a gutsy shot, but if that went in, that would have been the world for the Mono Vampires morale there. Both teams with costly turnovers early on. Mono Vampires going full court pressure here. Gets the ball in for then Bagyan on Freddie Goldstein. Good matchup there between these two smart players. Freddie Goldstein going inside. Gets blocked again by Anthony McLean. Tries to drop it off.
Gets his own rebound twice.
Freddie Goldstein just relentless at attacking the basket there. Love that sequence from Freddie Goldstein. He just went at the ball and Mike Fay.
It's like he teleported to the ball.
He didn't care how many times he was going to get blocked. Mike Fay, instant reply with that mid-range shot. He has been solid from the start. They take Bangkok City, looking to get the answer. It's Charles dribbling at Mike Fay.
Good gets move by move. Charles.
Offense suddenly picking up here for both teams. Hitting multiple shots in only the first 2 minutes. I take Bangkok City with a 9-point lead, but Freddie Bagan turns the ball over again. Wuti Pong Dasom trying to get the ball up. Looks to draw the pass. almost got the charge there, but he turned the ball over anyway. Bad pass there to Tyler Lamb.
That play there could have been called an offensive foul, actually, but lucky for him, just a regular turnover.
Ronkot, not a shooter. Dasson taking a step away there to meet at the basket. Nice pass to Anthony McClain, who's three bodies on him. Lucky to get out there. But he goes through, pushes it up. He has Nathakar and Mungbun on him. He's just subbed in. And goes in with a three. Misses completely. He knows that's on him. But he knows he has to get the offensive rhythm for him to go to get going in order for him to take Bangkok City to finish this game on a high note.
Freddie says, my bad.
Going in this game for Florida after the two turnover. Bay makes his way to the basket, draws a foul.
And one.
Michael Fay has been doing work in here.
And that's what he's good at, you know, Michael Fay. When he gets going, he's not going to stop. And he's going to put the ball up with his length and his height. He's going to be on the rim at least.
Could be the third foul on Christian Charles for Bangkok City. Christian Charles with the crisp pass there. He's channeled his inner point guard twice already in this game. I think Bangkok City with a quick reply to Michael Fay's offensive repertoire. A steal there by Wojibom Dasso, trying to push the ball up forward. Two Mono Vampires on him, and he turns the ball over again. That's something that Wojibom Dasso has got to look to improve. Sometimes he gets too much steam ahead in the fast break.
Ball handling.
Yeah, ball handling, passing. That's something he's got to improve if he wants to dominate this league as a local. Two floppy turnovers here already. Nice steal there almost, but Michael Fay misses the shot wildly there. Freddie Goldstein pushing it up again, and then setting up a three. Ice is another one.
Tyler Lamb having a field day.
Yep. For Tyler Lamb's splash, you have a pretty Goldstein splash there, the brothers. The bad boys, as you dime them. Little Vampires almost answered the three of their own, but Anthony was getting clobbered down low. He finally gets a foul called on him.
Now we got to convert it, make these two free throws.
Anthony McClain a bit not ready for that pass, but he ends up with the score anyways. Ends up with the foul anyways. So two quick fouls here in the quarter for Hi-Tech Bangkok City. 6 minutes left in the third quarter. Clay makes the first one. The offense for both teams picking up significantly here. But Hi-Tech Bangkok City takes a big advantage here. This is the second one. Chris Charles with a rebound. Already has a double-double here. 10 points and 11 rebounds. But he goes to stepping up. Nice pass to Dasso inside. Doesn't get the shot off. Ireland. Going at Radek Kutiwa, step back three.
He almost passed the ball to Goldstein.
Nice defense here from Mono Vampires, but in the end, Chris Charles just throws a dagger right at him. Mono Vampires had it held down, but that was just a better shot there from Chris Charles. Another almost steal there for Mono Vampires. Answer with a three for Radek Kutiwa. Always a good spark plug. This is a three-point shot of J.O. His second in the game. Dasso with the ball. Charles setting up high in the post here. Dasso goes all the way, and another block by Anthony McClay. He has just been eating up everything alive here.
That was a good move by Dasso.
Yeah, it was a good move.
If it was me, I would go straight to Biggie. Yeah. You know he's coming up top, so you got to make contact. You watch the NBA a lot. That's what the guards do. They just run into the wall.
Yeah, it's a good move, but might have wanted to finish a little bit more aggressively, maybe to draw the foul. Anthony McClain already has about 6 blocks in this game. He might finish with 10 if this pace continues.
An interesting thing about Mono Vampires, TK, is you know, when they make substitution, it's like a whole different team. So I think that the players or the subs, they gotta come in and they gotta be able to fill the same role as the starter.
Yeah.
Or vice versa.
Yeah, that's a good point, Pete. But this the coaching staff has only stepped in for only a couple of weeks after the New Year's, and their familiarity has been with the more of the starting core of the team, like Jo and the Rongpan. So it's gonna take a bit more time for them to gel the two local sides together. But they're on to a good start here. Let's hope it continues on for the Mono Vampires into the ABL campaign, and maybe it will end up in a playoff spot. But they have at least one thing to smile about, is that the Saigon Heat lost to the Kale Dragons earlier today. 109-60 points domination by the Kale Dragons.
Wow. Coach Gerbalato is not going to be happy tonight.
Yeah. Back to our game. High Tech with the ball. Milo Lam posting up. Gets the shot off. Doesn't make it though. Vampires gonna look for their offense. It's a 10-point game with 4 minutes and 30 seconds left in the third quarter. Chanachon Glahan back on the field. Almost a bad pass, but High Tech turns the ball over.
I'm liking what Chanachon is doing though. He's bringing what he brought earlier this game, and that's the aggressive drive to the rim.
Yeah, he's been a big factor in this game already. The wrong one again. Elbow swiping. Freddie Goldstein looks dazed there. Freddie Goldstein not having it right now. High Tech get the ball. Tries to inbound it in. Fish Charles breaking the press. Going point guard again. Going at Michael Fay. Nice move. Doesn't make it this time though. Mono Vampires get the ball again. Talk about a shift of power here. Mono Vampires slowly getting steam. Michael Fay again. Doesn't hit it this time. Thailand with a rebound. Thailand holds arms all the way. Chris Charles goes straight at the basket. Makes a dunk. Nice pass from Tyler Lamb. Nice move by Chris Charles, finishing over Anthony to play.
The defense of High Tech is very stable, and Mono's got to move the ball better.
Yep, they've been starting to figure out what Mono Vampires are going to do. Nice steal by Freddie Goldstein. He's going to go all the way here. Nope. Going a little bit too careless there, but Thailand finishes it anyway.
Coach Ruiz almost having a heart attack.
Thailand gets 2 rebounds out of that. Freddie Goldstein saying to get me my assist, bro.
I think I'm going to start this, what should I call it? You know, if you watch the NBA, they got Shaq and the Fool. I want to have him the Pete and the Fool, you know, for the ABL here.
We'll try to work that out, dude. So High Tech with the ball here again. Screen there. Freddie Goldstein attacking. Step shot. Easy two. Freddie Goldstein's coming into his zone right now.
Freddie Goldstein keeping it simple.
And you see here the High Tech Bangkok City have a 14-point lead, and the catalyst obviously has been Freddie Goldstein, who's been making his offense go. But Chanachon Glahan.
Wow, he is. Looks different.
Yeah. He's picked up right where he left off in that second quarter, aggressively attacking, finishing effectively. Four hit all four shots right now. Gasol with a three. Offense is just clicking here for High Tech in the second half. Everything is going in. Mono Vampires have got to find a way to respond. Nice try there, but Steve Thomas steps out of bounds. Almost a good steal.
A little bit of a rush pass by Klahan. I think he should have got to the spot. Fake to the right and then go up with that high shot. Faye wasn't quite ready for that one.
Let's see. Atapor and Lerner like Porn making his way under the court for Wittipon Gasol. Nice defense again by Tyler Lamb. Pass up front. They've got the numbers. 3-on-2. Freddie Goldstein goes all the way himself, and he finishes. Freddie Goldstein has come to life in this quarter, and the Mono Vampires are feeling it.
What did I say, DK?
Yep, he's going to find his offense eventually.
He's going to score no matter what. It's just a matter of how, you know.
Rade Kurtiva trying to get a little bit fancy. Another fast break here. Tyler Lamb draws the foul. That's an unsportsmanlike foul. Kurtiva obviously a bit frustrated at himself for the three-point misses. Goes straight at the rim. Oh, man. Kurtiva a bit slow to get to Tyler Lamb there. And he just made sure he got the foul. But a bit too aggressive at there.
And that's where, you know, the veteranness of Freddie Goldstein and Tyler Lamb comes in with their resume. They've played in Division I NCAA in the United States. And I'm sure they've seen bad calls. And I'm sure they've seen some bad boys in that league. So it's a lesson, that experience of composure for maybe Radet. Sometimes you're gonna get bad calls, and actually, I don't think it's a bad call. It was stripped, and you know, he's got to keep his frustration in the game.
Yep.
And another one is, can be predictable. This is two tie teams that know exactly what they're going against.
Yeah, they've played against each other a lot of times already.
And I'm sure Tyler Lamb knows that J.O. wants to shoot. That's actually what Florian Bagion is actually very good at, frustrating the opponent.
Yeah, he just gets into his head, but right now it's the other way around. I take getting to the head of Mono Vampires. It's been an offensive onslaught here for High Tech in the second half.
And I see Atapon finally making his way back on the court. It's his first time tonight.
But he's a veteran in that lineup. Veteran, local veteran.
Is this his first time on the court tonight?
Yep, this is his first time on the court tonight. He's been out for a while playing for his provincial team in the national basketball tournament in Thailand. Thailand makes the first free throw. Got distracted a little bit there, and he missed the free throw there, but Nitek gets the ball. Already with 25 points in this quarter, as opposed to the Mono Vampires 15. It's been a huge run. 18 point lead already. There's a guy who's done it all. Freddie Goldstein goes inside. Nice pass to Atapor. Nice pass.
Tyler Lamb for three. Does not hit the rim.
Can't finish it. Get the ball. But you can see that High Tech are looking more comfortable on offense. But Tyler Lamb with a pretty bad foul there away from the basket.
It's quite an interesting pass by Atapon. I think Tyler Lamb wasn't ready for it. A great penetration fake on for Atapon, though.
Yeah. Freddie Goldstein as well for the first initial drive to get Atapon the ball.
Definitely.
Gonna see Kanat Smirjai, Soro Tsunton Shiri in the court for Mono, and another turnover. Another fast break opportunity for High Tech.
Oh, watch your head.
Tyler Lamb and Chris Jones connects from the alley-oop again.
And it's not looking good for Mono Vampires now. Down 20.
20. Lead for High Tech again. They're just turning the ball over again and again. And
great layup by Gahan.
Gahan is just keeping Mono Vampires in this game as much as he can. Another great play. Gets to the line. Aggressiveness is the key. And right now, the only player doing it is Shanachon Gahan. Boylan Bagyong gets in the court for Summer Jai and Pyeongwon subbing out Tyler Lim, who's had a marvelous game here. All around, rebounding, passing, shooting. Completing the three-point play there, the Mono Vampires cut it to 17. And again, a turnover. The line is deceiving there. Hatteborn, his first time playing in Chulalongkorn University Stadium. Steps on the line, turns the ball over. But there are plenty of lines there on the court. The blue, the green, the white. They just have to get used to that. Boylan Bagyong passes to Sorok. Drives to the basket. Tries to drop it off. Michael Fay gets it somehow. Misses it this time. Freddie Goldstein is working his magic here, breaking through the press. Just dribbling through everyone.
Freddie Goldstein, like a flash.
A little bit too hopeful there. Misses the three-point shot, but Hitek still with the ball. Shot clock not on the screen. 10 seconds left. Freddie Goldstein is going to end it. Shanachon Gahan gets out of the way. What a layup. Freddie Goldstein somehow gets inside, throws it up. Ends the half, it's the quarter. I take Bangkok. ASEAN Basketball League at Chulalongkorn University Stadium. Boylan Bagyong starts off the fourth quarter with a breakaway layup.
Goldstein.
The man of the hour, Freddie Goldstein. Tries to shake it off. Off the foot of Mike Bay. Hitek's going to get a second chance.
63-46. High Tech Bangkok City up quite a bit as Charles takes up short two, gets his own rebound.
Offensive rebound again there for High Tech Bangkok City, another crucial part of this game. Freddie Goldstein breaks his way to the basket. Floater over Anthony McClain, can't get it. Mono Vampires on the run. Surat Suntan Siri drops it to McClain. Nice layup, nice fast break for the Mono Vampires. This is how they want to start the quarter off. Down to a 15-point lead for High Tech Bangkok City. See if they can fly there. So we go through it again, setting it up. Chris Charles with a good game.
Thomas, what a nice move.
But can't finish it off. China Chong with the rebound, pushing the fast break again. But doesn't have the numbers this time. Anthony McClain a bit slow to get up. He's been playing all game, and he's been running all game, too. Gets the ball inside here, going up against Chris Charles. Chris Charles fouls him down low. Let's see how many fouls Chris Charles have. That's that is going to be Chris Charles' fourth foul already with 8 minutes and 30 seconds left. That's a huge point for
him. Oh, good take on Sorok.
Just keep getting worse for the High Tech. Sorok Suntan Siri makes a shot there. And Charles has got to be careful. Four fouls on him already. Might say no. Waiting for the basket.
Shot.
Fours anyway. Tech still up by 15, but Mono Vampires have looked a lot better in the start of the fourth quarter. And then Bagyan trying to work it out. Bay gets Charles up in the air, goes to the basket, gets the late whistle. Should be on Steve Thomas.
Good take by Bay to be aggressive in a time where they need free throws the most.
He knows he can shoot. Charles knows he can shoot. Makes the fake and goes straight at the basket. Good play there. Michael Fay with 12 points and 6 rebounds. Looking to add on to that. After starting quickly, he kind of faded away in the third quarter. Gets started with a free throw here in the fourth. We're gonna see Sukhdev Gogar making his way onto the court for Christian Charles, as well as Tyler Lamb and Wotipong Dasong. The team up with Freddie Goldstein and Steve Thomas. Struggling to put the ball in there. Almost 5 seconds, and again, Pongasso with a crucial turnover. Stephen Thomas not liking that.
High Tech having a little difficulty with the press.
Still plenty of basketball left. Nice defense there by Tyler Lamb. Gets his hand on the ball. So Rudd's going to inbound the ball.
When you think of the ABL and you think of the full court press, who do you think of, PK?
I think of the Singapore Slingers, though. But what do you think of, PK?
Yeah, Singapore Slingers and the KL Dragons.
Yeah,
do that quite well.
Yeah, some teams missing shots there. Berlin Bakion weaving his way, misses the shot. Steven Thomas gets a rebound. They need to get this basket. We just settle down, get the basket somehow. See what Freddie Goldstein works out. Tyler Lamb has Foylan Bagyan on him. See if they work it out. Gets Sukhdev at that mid-range position. Goldstein weaving his way. Gets Michael Fay to go the other way. What a crossover by Freddie Goldstein. Gets the easy layup out of nowhere.
Baby Iverson.
Baby Iverson is getting Fay confused there. So what? Trying to get up. Gets Fay.
Good pass. Nice finish.
They know they have the size advantage now that there's 2 7-footers in the court, and both of them are Mono Vampires. So they keep going inside and make Sukhdev get his defense on.
Very nice pass by Fei and a good finish by McLean.
Yep. Wutipong Dasong doesn't finish. Freddy Goldstein can't get the rebound. Sorot gas on the pedal. And the ball is just going around everywhere. Michael Fei gets the sets of the three. And he hits it. Big shot by Michael Fei. Lead is down to 13 points. But the Mono Vampires have got the momentum going their way here in the fourth quarter. Michael Fei has come up huge once again. Looking for a way to figure themselves out before they end this game. 13-point lead for Hitech Bangkok City, but the way the game has been playing, it doesn't seem like a large lead at all. What do you think about this start for the fourth quarter for the Mono Vampires, Pete?
Well, you remember what I said in halftime? It's going to be kind of a grind-out physical game, and points are going to come from sloppiness. And the person who has prevailed from it so far is Michael Fei. He has got the loose ball and made something happen with it. So for Mono Vampires, they just got to look to be more precise on their passing, move the ball well, and just keep grinding it out. And hope that Hitech keeps making mistakes. And let's see how it goes from here on. 6 minutes left.
Still applying the full court pressure for Mono Vampires. 10-point lead here after that three from Michael Fei. Goldstein looking to create. Michael Fei just standing there still.
Good pass.
Woo! Freddy Goldstein is lighting it up every way possible. Getting to the basket, dropping off the pass. He has been the catalyst of everything going on in this game in the second half.
But like I said, TK, you remember? Fei hits another three.
They are just trading bars right now. Yeah. Boylan Barkley with a nice drop pass to Fei for the three.
As I said earlier, TK, Freddy Goldstein's an A-plus player. He might not be scoring. He'll do something else.
And he's showing it. But Michael Fei as well coming up huge. Back-to-back three-point.
Lamb for three.
Tyler Lamb answers back. Oh, what a game this is. This is Thailand basketball, everyone. Boylan Barkley bringing the ball up. Sukdev Gogar is just shadowing Michael Fei there, even at the three-point line. Boylan Barkley with a nice pass in the corner. Chanachon can't take that shot. And he gets it to Fei. Ball's going around. Sorot goes to the basket, and he misses.
Still gets the ball back. Somehow
Fei with a step back.
Oh, man, you made that one.
And Hitech is it. Reply. What a pass there by Steve Thomas.
Man, an amazing finish by Goldstein. Didn't even look at the rim, it seemed like.
Good poise by both players. Steve Thomas acknowledging Freddie and making the pass. Freddie Goldstein just finishing that somehow. Mono Vampires, despite the momentum they've built, still down by 14. Boylan again. Good pass to McLean. And it bobbles out there.
Goldstein made a good decision by not throwing the ball.
4 minutes left here in the fourth quarter.
Lamb, long two, no good.
And Lamb got to watch out for those backboard fouls. Boylan Barkley with behind the pass to Chanachon, who turns the ball over. Chris Charles is going to make his way back in the court, but good minutes there from Sukdev Gogar, except for the three-point shot from Michael Fei. Who really saw that coming, though? And again, Hitech Bangkok City just goes on. Another block by McLean. he constantly still struggling to finish over with Thane, but seems like he's put a mission to do that in this game. And long pass! Another three! They have come on fire here from the three-point line in this quarter. Goldstein almost loses the ball, and he finally does. Goldstein not liking what he saw there. A lot of contact. Walking it up.
Got held a little bit there.
Ball up, dribbling around, looking for options. Gets Michael Fay. Doesn't hit it this time, and it's still more November high ball. Three minutes left into the game. The Mono Vampires down by 11, but the emotions are running high. Samurjai with the breakaway. Defensive collapse there by High Tech Bangkok City. And it's a single-digit game. Nice play acknowledging that High Tech Bangkok City weren't ready, and they took advantage of it. High lift makes his way to the basket. Chris Charles
with a reverse slam. Chris Charles
getting young legs there. Nice drop pass from Tyler Lev. Fantastic finish from Chris Charles. And he makes Bay think about taking that shot. Another defense. Tyler Lev on Foylan Bagyan. Trying to get the pick and pop there. Foylan with a step on the line, but misses it completely.
Tough shot for Bagyan to have to shoot over the 6'5", 6'6", Tyler Lamb.
Yep. Nice defensive adjustment there.
Coach Ruiz got a nice plan with that, having Lamb guard Bagyan.
Yep. Nice pass, Freddie Goldstein. Tyler Lamb loses it, tries to drop it in. Steve Thomas with the ball. Ball is just wiggling around. Another block by McClay. Mono Vampires on offense, and they're going to settle right free. Misses it this time, and they're down 2 minutes. And Chris Charles, that's a huge call. The wrong part goes to the floor. Chris Charles knows him. See that again. Oh. The crowd reacting, the camera got a view of what happened down there, but nonetheless, Chris Charles has called for his fifth personal foul, and he makes his way to the bench after fouling out.
I think that was a bad call on that one, but not to discredit the referees, because the referees can only see as much as they can see.
Yep.
But the credit you have to give to is Duran Bunna.
Yeah, he knows those angles. He knows how to work them out, but yeah, good point. The refs can't see everything. Sometimes these things just slip by. Unfortunately, this time the camera caught the action.
Well, this is a throwing league, and this is a very entertaining and quality league. Everything you see and all the flaws that are in the league, it's going to get better year in year, and it has been getting better, and I'm really enjoying this ABO league.
Yeah, six seasons in, this has been very entertaining.
Can you imagine being the ref, DK? It's a hard job.
They heard it from the crowds in that late last play.
Stressful too.
Yep. Going to start off the last few minutes of the fourth quarter here. High Tech with the lead, but they're going to be without their reigning back-to-back World Import MVP after Chris Charles fouled out. He's been having a monster game, though. Right now, Sudev Gogar's got to pick up the pieces. Chris Charles leaves the game with 20 points and 18 rebounds.
Wow.
That's going to be a hit. Mono Vampires inbound the ball. Try to get it all the way up there. Deron Pine at the half court. Nassau playing defense on him. And Fay ends up with the ball. Mid-range shot. Can't hit. Summer tied with the offensive rebound. Open for three. misses. Rohan doesn't get the foul. And a bad pass by Sukhdev Gokar. Mono Vampires still have the ball. 1 minute 30 left. And a high take bench. I was hearing that pass from Sukhdev Gokar. Another chance for Mono Vampires to cut into this lead for their final run. Samarjai all the way to the basket. Can't hit it still. They're playing, getting physical. Can't get it. Does it with the ball. And he tries to bring up the ball. Watch out for that. And finally gets a foul called. The Rohan Abhirom Vilachai with the foul.
1.5 minute is a long time, but it's not that long of a time. I think High Tech has just got to calm down and get to their sets. Great job by Mono Vampires, of course, for making them rush.
Yep. 16 seconds on the shot clock. Mono Vampire, High Tech Steakhouse is going to milk it out. Freddy Goldstein again goes somewhere, gets the option. Steve Thomas with the cold shot. But give the credit to Freddy Goldstein for getting in there and creating a shot out of nowhere. That pretty much ices it.
Blocked by Lamb.
Tyler Lamb says, get that.
Tyler Lamb has been reading the scout report. He knows who does what.
Interestingly, their sharpshooter, Radek Kratiwa, is still on the bench for the Bono Vampires. And Michael Fay is still on there, so see what they run. Shit the pong, throw it rod, misses the three. Freddy goes in with the rebound. Wrong pun hounding him, and he gets a steal out of it. Stephen Thomas is going to wait for the wrong pun, but hit the point with the three, and he makes it. Giving the Mono Vampires some life there.
Relentless the Mono Vampires are. They are relentless.
So 30 seconds left, the Mono Vampires cut it to the within 10. Still very much alive. They just need a defensive stop or two.
Great energy for Mono Vampires to not give up. But Freddy Goldstein
creating that shot out of nowhere. This has been the storyline for the Mono Vampires the whole year. However, they've always found themselves in a big lead, big deficit early on. And they've always showed the spirit to make a comeback, but they haven't really been able to get over that hump. With 30 seconds left, down by 10, let's see if they can finish it off this time. The Rong Pineapple Romy Lai Chai, Kanat Sumerjai, Chittapong Toerot, Anthony McLean, and Michael Fay for the Mono Vampires. Freddy Goldstein, Stephen Thomas, Sukhdev Gokar, Tyler Lamb, and Wuti Pong Dao Song for High Tech. Freddy Goldstein playing along there with Kana Samarjai, dribbling it out. He knows he has time, doesn't need to rush. Makes a drive, somehow gets it in there, gets the shot off, can't finish it though, but ball, Mono Vampires trying to run it off. See the ball, fakes a three, Samarjai can't hit. McClay gets it inside, loses the ball, Steve Thomas gets it, and a foul on Anthony McClay. 4 seconds left, that should pretty much ice it for High Tech Bangkok City. What an effort it has been for the Mono Vampires.
It's been a grind out game. I give both the teams a lot of credit. Other team has been able to do what they wanted to do, but the skilled, high-tech Bangkok City players have prevailed.
Mono Vampire's side of the cheering stands are getting a little bit quiet, but you have to give credit for them rooting on all game. They've been there for this team, and it seems seems to be that's the way we're going to end it. 78-68, I take Bangkok City. Take it against the Mono Vampires on their home court in their third matchup of the Bangkok City Brawl. What a game it has been. It's been a story of runs here in this game. Started out with Hitek Bangkok City in the first quarter, going with the fast breaks, taking a 12-point lead early on. But Mono Vampires, with the aggressiveness of Chanasung Klahan and Kanan Sumerjai, made a run back in the second quarter to close in on that gap. But then again, in the second half, Freddie Goldstein came alive, and that set the tone for the Hitek Bangkok City team throughout the game. So here are the stats for the game. We saw Hitek Bangkok City shooting significantly better in the second half, rising up to 41%, but the Mono Vampires couldn't get over the hump. They sticked around at 35.1. Significant players is player of the game, Tyler Lamb, who scored a total of 24 points, grabbed 8 rebounds, and hit 4 three-point shots, putting Hitek Bangkok City up to the win. So yeah, let's go with our courtside reporter, Penny Lane, with the interviews.
First of all, congratulations on your win today, Coach. What do you think were the strongest points that helped your team win today?
Well, the teamwork that we were like implementing everybody, and we capitalized it like from the first quarter up to the last quarter to stay together. Yeah.
All right. Well, there are 8 matches left in the ABL. How are you going to prepare your team for each and every match?
Well, right now, like we're in the middle of adjusting and putting more. Of our place, and we have to try to go and make sure that everybody's healthy.
All right, well, thank you so much, Coach. Congratulations once again. Thank you. And now for the MVP of the match, Mr. Tyler Lamb. First of all, congratulations on your win today. Tell me, are you happy with your performance today?
Thank you, and yes, I am. I'm happy with our team's performance. I feel like we came out here and we played really well after a long break, so I'm excited about that.
Is this your first game after the long break?
Yes, it is.
Well, congratulations once again. Thank you.
Thanks.
Back to you, Pete.
So a huge win here by Hitek Bangkok City to win the game 78-68. Key performers, obviously, other than Tyler Lamb, who scored 24 points, is Freddie Goldstein, who came from scoring 0 points to 14 second half points along to go with 9 assists and 8 rebounds, almost a triple-double from one of the best point guards in the ABL. Talk something a little bit about Freddie Goldstein, Pete, because I'm lost for words.
Well, you know, as I said, you know, Freddie Goldstein's going to get his points no matter what. In the previous games, he's learned that he can't get too hot too quick. He's got to set the pace, set the tone for his teammates. So great job by him. The buckets aren't going the first half. Let's dish it off the second half. So good job for Freddie Goldstein.
Yep. So also for the Mono Vampires, they got a huge game out of Mike Faye, 20 points. And those 2 3-point shots that really almost brought the Mono Vampires back in. But wasn't enough, and they're going to have to step into their next games. High Tech Bangkok City are going to be hosting the Saigon Heat on the 13th at their home court. And the Mono Vampires are going to be hosting the KL Dragons here at CU Sports Complex. If you have the time, please do come. They have these great jerseys on sale. Just come. The atmosphere here is awesome. The Mono Vampires here, the girls are great. Everyone's here is enjoying basketball, and we'd love for everyone to enjoy the atmosphere here too if you have the chance. So that's it for today. We were the High Tech Bangkok City and the Mono Vampires game from the ABL season 6. Until next time.